Dear children, today we are going to continue with HCF and LCM in Mathematics chapter number 3. Today we are going to learn a new topic on HCF and LCM. The topic is factorizing a number into its prime factor. A simple but important rule given by USID is often used to find the GCD, that is greatest common divisor, or HCF, that is highest common factor, and LCM, that is least common multiplier of numbers. The rule says that any composite number can be written as a product of prime number. Now, dear children, we will see through an example how to factorize a number into its prime factor. So we have a number 24 here. There are two methods to solve the prime factor. One is vertical arrangement, another is horizontal arrangement. First, let us learn how to solve the vertical arrangement. Now I have a number called 24 here. So that the 24 is divisible in two tables. So 2, when I divide, I'll get answer 12. So 2 12s are 24. Next, 2 is divisible in 2, 12 is divisible in 2 tables. So 2 6 are 12. Again, a 6. 6 is divisible in 2 tables. 2 3s are 6. 3 1s are 3. Okay, now horizontal arrangement. The horizontal arrangement, that is for the 24. The 24 can be written as 2 into 12. Now, 2 is already a prime number, so it cannot be again a factorized. Now 12 can be factorized as 2 6 are. So I am having 2, this 12 is written as 2 into 6. Now 6 can be factorized, right? So this 2 into 2 and this is 6 is factorized as 2 into 3. Therefore, the factorization of 24 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Therefore, the prime factor are 2 and 3. So now we have to remember to write a given number as a product of its prime factor is a factorize it into prime. Again, remember to write a given number as a product of its prime factors is to factorize it into prime. Now let us solve problem set 11 and learn how to do it more. Factorize the following numbers into prime. Question number 1, 32. Before we solve, let us learn how to factorize. We have already seen before that. Okay, so I'm in the unit place, I'm having a 2 here. So the number in the unit place, the number which ends with 2, 4, 6, 8, 0, that will be always divisible by 2. The number in the unit place which ends with 0 and 5, it is divisible by 5 table. The number which is end with 0, that is divisible by 10 table. Okay, this we have already learned in the 6th standard, so we are going to follow that only. Okay, so first we will solve the vertical arrangement. So 32, the number that is ending with 2, so it is divisible by 2 tables. So 2 16s are again 16, 16 2 6 is divisible by 2 tables. So 2 8s are 16, 2 4s are 8, and 2 2s are 4, last is 2 1s are 2. Okay, now this is vertical arrangement. Now let us see horizontal arrangement. 32 is written as 2 into 16. Now we are going to factorize 16. 16 can be written as 2 into 8. Now 8 can be factorized as 2 into 4. Don't forget to write the following numbers, that is 2 into 2 into 8, factorization is 2 into 4. Further, the last is 2 into 2 into 2 into So therefore, the factorization of 32 is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. Now let us solve question number 3, that is 23. So the number in the unit place is 3. So 23 is already a prime number, you all know. So the prime number, so it can be written as the vertical form, that is 23 ones are 23. Now let us solve the horizontal arrangement. Horizontal is 23 ones are. Therefore, the factorization of 23 is 23 into 1. Now, question number 5, that is 216. The number in the unit place is 6, so it is divisible by 2 tables, sorry. So, 2162, when I divide, I'll get 108. So, again, 108 is divisible by 2 table, so 254. Okay, when I divide, I'll get answer as 54. Now 54 is divisible by, again, number ending with 4, so it is divisible by 2 table, so 227s are. The 27 is a factor of 3 table, that is 3 9s are 27. Okay, now 9 is a nine that comes in which table? 3 table. 3 threes are 9. So last is 3. 3 ones are 3. Now let us do the horizontal arrangement. So 216 can be written as 2 into 108. Now next line, 2 multiply 108 can be factorized as 2 into 54. Next, 2 into 2 into 54 can be factorized as 2 into 27. 2 into 2 into 2 into 27 can be factorized as 3 9s are 27. 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. 9 can be factorized 3 into 3. Therefore, our answer is 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Dear children, can you see the marks? By this way, you can understand easily, okay? So, at the end, I should get prime number. That is why it is called as a prime factor, okay? Question number 7. The question is 765. Here it is wrong, okay? 765. Here the number is ending with 5, okay? So it is divisible by 5 table. When I divide, children, I'll get 153. So 153, which is divisible by 3 table. So 3, when I divide by 153 by 3, I'll get answer as 51. The 51, when I divide by 3 table, I'll get 17. 17 ones are 17. Okay, now horizontal arrangement. So 765 can be written as 5 multiply 153 can be further factorized as 3 51s are. Okay, so 5 into 3 into 51 can be further factorized as 3 into 17. 17 cannot be further factorized because 17 is a prime number. Prime number, a number which is divisible by its own number, then that is called as a prime number. So 17 is divisible by its own table. So we will stop it here. So our answer is 5 into 3 into 3 into 17. Okay. Question number 10. 559. 559 is divisible by 13 table. Okay, 13, 43 is 43 is a odd number. Sorry, it's a prime number. So 43 ones are 43. Now horizontal 559, that is 13 multi-factorize. When I factorize 13 into 43, 43 is already prime number, so it cannot be further factorized. Therefore our answer is 559, answer is 13 into 43. Dear children, teacher has solved 5 sums from this exercise. You will solve remaining all the sums, not only remaining sums, all the sums from this practice sets in your notebook in a neat and clean handwriting. Understand well and do it. If you understand the sums, further exercise will be understanding. You will understand very clearly. Okay. Thank you. God bless you all.